Murder. We hear them. What is this? A strange weapon. Noises in the cellar. There is a threat here. Books. Gems. And flowers. We will take a flower. These do not sound like skeevers. They are not. They are creatures from the under. Strange. Listen, creatures. What is that sound you hear? Is it us? Is the sound. Dangerous. murderers. So Shadeling is going to investigate this. Begs the question, what does he remember of family? Does he remember anything of it? Maybe. Doesn't seem like it now. But perhaps his memories will return. All right. We're going to go with the Frost Cloak and Unarmed Combat. We'll see where that gets us. Okay, we got a mage. We're going to rush her. So I've been getting some questions about how does this unarmed combat work? Well, it's a combination of things, to be honest. It's a combination of light armor. Combination of light armor and destruction, and sometimes stealth. You may notice that sometimes if the lighting is just right, when you see him throw a punch, there's an aura that will project out from his fist as if it were a wave. That's actually an aura of elemental cold magic that projects from his fists, which is really kind of a cool effect. And that's a specialization. I believe that it actually comes from light armor, I'm pretty sure. Eliminate that one.
shot in the back. That's no good. He was practically on top of us. Okay, so this is the way we came in, right? We blew that one off of the ledge up there. Okay. It's a horror show down here. All right, let's take a look at what we got going on here. I think it might be kind of interesting for us to try some tricks. What do you say? We'll queue up some evil twin. Ghost walk in the left hand in case we get into some hot water. I'm curious to see how illusion spells will affect the Falmer and their minions. Come on, evil twin. Take a bite. You gotta fight, man. Dispatched. As Marl would say, dispatched. I think in the past when I've talked about this character being complicated, it in part has to do with the fact that, you know, how does he, how does he view life and death, you know? Is it important to him to save people other than Marl? Does he value life? My answer to that is, I think he's learning to value life. And I think that in his dialogue, with Marl that we witnessed in episode 8 of Ashes. I think what we saw there was that by the end of that situation, we were starting to see some expression. We were starting to see him express himself in a more human way, with laughter. He was actually, at one point, he was making fun of Marl, telling Marl he was bossy, and telling him he wasn't going to listen to his advice about dusting because Marl was being too bossy, you know? So we're slowly starting to see some things return, which coincides with us also, the viewers, of course, learning a bit more about Shadeling's background. So, as we learn these things, I think we'll be more inclined to start seeing other emotions showing up as well. Look at that. He's branded each one of those pods. It's like his own personal brand, his wizard mark. We'll start to see other emotions show up as well. We saw shame, perhaps a little bit of anguish when he was talking about, you know, being ashamed that he had destroyed his hood, which also displayed something else interesting, an kind of artificial sense of importance that he has placed on what others would probably view as some strange things, right? Yeah, you wrecked your hood, so what, you know? This point we're like exterminators. Okay. Ghost walk up here. We want to get sucked back up onto that ledge if anything goes bad. By the looks of this place, it sort of feels like the things could go pear-shaped anytime. So I think what I'm driving at is that Shadeling is embarked on this little mission right here, investigating what happened in this lighthouse. He was drawn into the lighthouse by a dead horse. A horse laying out in front of, obviously, what is a dwelling. Right? Still saddled. Indicating that it was killed in a violent way. That attracted his attention. And there's something inside him that told him he should investigate. What is it that... What emotion is it that he's following? My sense is that it's sort of this... this kind of... budding idea that... that life has value. There, that's huge. Damn. Jeez. Regroup. Let's move forward. Oh, Oh, I killed the Reaper. Already. It's just a regular. Sorry, I'm just trying to concentrate. Gotcha. I think that was the last of them. Yeah, one of my runes got this guy. Hod's remains. Good God. Ugh. Key. This is like the mother load of Charis eggs, right? I mean, if you collected everything in here, you'd be probably set for invisibility potions for a very, very long time. Okay, we don't know if there's anyone in there. But if there is, we could certainly cause trouble for them in a big hurry. Do it? Where does this spit us out? Ah, okay. Little recon. Alright. I got you. We did a nice neat loop. Look at that. They've incorporated shovels into their totem. That is awesome. The Falmer sword. We'll take that Falmer sword. Shadeling is curious. He's going to keep it and ask Marl if he knows what it is. He would know it's a sword, but he wants to understand what these creatures are. Oh, look at brooms as well. Oh, funny. Brooms incorporated into their totems. That's crazy.
It is a hat. We will take it for Marl. Marl likes hats very much. Shadeling knows this. Are there more hats? No hats. Too bad. Danger. It is a house of light. Like Shadeling's house. A house of light. Soul gem. Power.
All right, everybody. I don't know if you just noticed that, but when I went up to the lighthouse, House Brazier, and activated it, it took the bloody remains of the guy Hobbed that we found down below and placed it in the brazier when I clicked on it. I did not know that that was going to happen, and it said that some kind of new power, I'm assuming that it's a passive power, Sailor's Repose, healing spells cure 10% more. Awesome. That is a really cool. Now, that's amazing, because that's one of those little things, if you weren't paying attention, you could have totally missed it. I happened to be looking up there in the upper left-hand corner of my screen when I clicked on that. Otherwise, you know, if I hadn't been paying attention for the brief second, I never would have known what happened. I just would have said, hey, the bloody skull's not in my inventory. What happened? And then I would have eventually seen that kind of innate power or whatever it is and not understood where it came from. So, yeah, very cool. Okay. Shadeling is trying to understand people. Did you just hear a voice? I swear I heard somebody say, "Is someone there?" when I cast that spell. So look, right? Look at this. This woman, Ramadi, is dead. She was obviously executed by a Falmer. Then we've got a chair here and a bunch of empty Nord Mead bottles. Like, the Falmer show up, kill her, kidnap the children. He comes home, finds his wife dead. Perhaps he comes home and he finds the Charis here. He kills it himself with the woodcutter's axe, and then he sits here and he drinks himself into a stupor until he's brave enough to go after the kids, and then he goes. Out he goes. Following the trail of blood. I'm gonna cast that spell again, see if we can hear it. I swear to God I heard that. Yes, there it is. Is somebody there? I'm definitely not hearing things. That is... Sorry, y'all. I gotta... I don't know. It could be what I'm hearing is it sounds like a whisper when I'm putting this spell away. I could have swore it sounded like somebody saying, "Is somebody there?" You know how they do that when you're sneaking and whatever, they can't see you. Is somebody there? Given this whole scene, it had this effect of making me feel like maybe after sticking his remains in the brazier up there, getting that special benefit, maybe it was his ghost whispering to us. Maybe his ghost is in here now. I don't know. It's probably my imagination. I swear I heard it clear as a bell the first time, but I'll listen back to the recording. It'd be like forensics. All right, off we go. The journey continues. Now, the last time that I recorded content for Ashes, I ended up with a lot of content, 2.5 hours worth, and I split it into 2 episodes. That's why we had 2 episodes of Ashes before an episode of Ashes 2. It's because I felt compelled to break it up. But in the interest of keeping the stories in sync, I needed to release all the content. The same will probably be true here. I'm creating a lot of content right now. We've been at this for a while. So I may break this up too.
Star. The lady wants the star, but the man also wants the star. We must acquire more power. We hope our mother will not get upset with Shadeling. We do not wish to upset Mother, but we must do the right thing. Shadeling must survive. Survival is important. Hunters in trouble. It is safe now. Oh, you attack us. Why? Shadeling does not understand mortals yet. We have more to learn. This is where the man told us to go. Bring the star, he said. Do not bring it to the lady. Bring it to us. The star contains a taint, which must be eliminated. It would be unwise for the Shadeling to use the star with a taint. That would be dangerous. There is a dangerous creature of the frozen north. Shadeling is a dangerous creature of the frozen north. Ha ha ha! Marl would have liked that. Seek the man. The elf man.
I understand Irid's been playing hunt the elf again.
It's just children playing, Irid. I wouldn't fret over it.
Hello.
Stendar's mercy. You found it.
It Azora's had nothing star. To do with Stendar.
Maybe this is my chance to make things right. I can finish Malin's work the way we had meant to before his madness. It would mean cutting the star off from Azora. Only black souls would be able to enter it once we finished.
The lady would not care for a star containing taint. Let us repair it.
Give me a minute to examine the star. I'll see what we'll need to do. These fissures and cracks aren't encouraging. Malin obviously was growing more desperate once he left the college. He did it. He actually managed to trap his own soul inside the star, but it's falling apart. It needs more and more souls to sustain itself. The star is being used to sustain Malin's soul. I can't fix it while that fragment of him is inside.
So, we need to expel Malin from the star.
Precisely. But it's not as simple as enchanting Malin away. He's put up barriers. Souls are only allowed in, not out. If we were to somehow send a soul inside the star, one that was ready to overpower Malin from the inside...
You may send our souls inside the star.
A special type of soul trap, placing you inside the star without fully killing you. Once Malin has been dealt with, I'll bring you back. I understand if you need some time to prepare. Let me know when you're ready.
No time is required. Proceed.
Okay, stand very still. This might sting. First, I'll need to grab hold of your soul. Now, take a deep breath.
I think Bearden might disagree with you.
Ah, my disciples have sent me a fresh soul. Good. I was getting hungry. Why, there's something different about you.
There is. Your time is over, Malin. Your fate is sealed.
And who are you to challenge me? I have conquered mortality itself.
We are Shadeling.
This is my realm now. I've sacrificed too much to let you take it from me.
Thank you.
Malin's enchantments are broken. Hold on. I'm going to pull your soul out of there. Brace yourself.
Come on in. Just stoked the fire. Take a seat and get the cold out.
Easy there. The numbness will pass. Just don't strain yourself.
We are always numb.
The star has been cut off from Azura, and Malin's soul finally has some measure of peace, even if it is non-existence.
I understand.
The Lady's star is repaired. I shall keep it.
Go ahead, take it. I'd sooner finally put this chapter of my life behind me. Congratulations. You've altered the fate of a Daedric artifact, and lived. Until next time.
We have also occupied